My invisible friends, hello and welcome back to our series on electrical engineering. This is the last of a group of videos dedicated to power in AC steady state. Two independent sources, a voltage source 16 volts with 30 degrees on the left, and a current source 19 amps with 10 degrees on the top center, they energize a circuit that has one inductor, one capacitor, two resistors, and one dependent current source. In this circuit, they ask us what is the RMS value of the current in the capacitor IX, which happens to be the controlling current to the dependent source. They are also asking us what is the complex power delivered by that dependent current source. You know what I'm going to do. I will choose a reference node, identify the two nodes 1 and 2, and next choose the direction for the currents in the branches IA, IB, and IC. I go to the calculator, the HP prime, define the variable V source and I source with the corresponding values. 16 with 30 degrees, 19 with 10 degrees. And next, I define who is IA, IB, IC, and IX. Those are not equations. Those are merely definitions. We are telling the calculator how to compute the value of IA, IB, IC, and IX if we know what are the values of V1 and V2, and we will know them. Now the calculator has it. We can write the K-scale equations for node 1 and 2 very succinctly. K-scale for node 1, currents going in, only one, IA. Currents leaving node 1, there are three of them. The current source on the top, IB in the middle, and IX through the capacitor at the bottom. And for K-scale 2, we have three currents entering the node, the current source, IB, and 2 times IX, and leaving the node we have IC. Solve the system of those two equations for V1 and V2 and extract those values from the vector X and put them in the variables V1 and V2 as soon as the calculator knows the values for V1 and V2, because it has the definitions of IA, IB, IC, and IX. The calculator automatically recomputes those four currents. And we can ask directly using Steinmetz complex power formula. What is the polar form of the current IX, rectangular to polar of IX? Oh, that is 10.95 amperes with 135 degrees. That is the current in the capacitor. Those are, of course, RMS amps. Why? Because the two sources were giving us RMS phasors. And now the complex power in the capacitor. That is using Steinmetz formula, the voltage in the capacitor V1 multiplied by the complex conjugate of the current in the capacitor IX. That is the complex power in the capacitor. The capacitor is absorbing negative 120 vars. So that means that the capacitor is actually delivering 120 vars. Why do I say it's absorbing negative 120? Because that current IX is flowing from high volts to low volts. That's why the computation is of absorbed power. And for the dependent source, SDS, the complex power is voltage in the source, which is V2, multiplied by the complex conjugate of the current in the source, 2 times IX. That is the power delivered by the dependent source, 582 watts and negative 148 vars. Why do I say that is delivered power? Because that current in that dependent source is flowing from low volts, the reference, to high volts, node number 2. And finally, we want to write that complex power in the dependent source in polar form so that we can see what are the kVAs or the VAs, the apparent power in that source, 600.5 volt amperes, and the power factor angle seen by the source, which is negative 14 degrees. And that is that. That is the solution. My invisible friends, thank you very much for joining in today. And thank you for watching this entire series dedicated to a tutorial recitation on power in AC steady state.